Ready. La plus amusante ville du monde et la plus philosophique. Paris, the most amusing city in the world and the most frightening. The dress I'm wearing was made for me by Pierre Balmain in 1952 or 1954, actually. I don't remember. Of course, this isn't the original. One can't keep everything. This is a copy I've had made especially for tonight. I was 19 when I first wore it. It was my first big costume ball, really. Splendeur et misère, le Paris du temps de Balzac. Ah, Paris. Les balles, les concerts, les danses, les salons splendides du Faubourg Saint-André, brillants des bougies. Quelle fête! Quel luxe! Insolente! Mais ces gens doivent avoir une fortune immense! D'où viennent-ils? Qui sont-ils, mes chéris? Vous ne savez donc pas? Well, they had a point. Whose house is this? Whose party is this? Where did the money come from? Where did the money come from? No one ever really talked about that, though everyone was talking. Everyone was talking all the time. I used to hate that sometimes. Where did all the money come from? The flowers, the champagne, the clothes, the shoes, the nights at the opera. Are you married? Engaged? Can I get you a drink? Can I? Is this your first time here? Have you seen the ballroom? It's absolutely magnificent. Do you waltz ever? Can I see you again? It wasn't easy wearing those clothes. I used to hate it sometimes. Jeune femme. Une des plus ravissantes femmes du bal. D'une beauté qui inspirait l'amour. Élégante et jeune, blanche et rose le cou, les bras, le corsage nu et blanc. Une robe de satin gris et rose. You see, this is the dress I was wearing on the night when I first heard her. Her voice. When I heard it, I thought it was the most beautiful thing I'd ever heard. It was perfect. It was perfect, and I was 19. And I was very proud of my dress. All the guests were in some kind of costume. And I can remember that the entire house was lit only by candlelight. It was all supposed to be in period, you see, and that was why they had hired her. And in the middle of the ball, at midnight, she appeared in a great black robe. Les splendeurs et les misères. She wasn't dressed as a woman. But everyone said, well, you know, he's not a man. And so we looked at our programs. Zambinella. People said, Zambinella, well, what is that supposed to mean? Is it supposed to be a man or is it a woman? And I can remember thinking, well, that's too beautiful to be a man. And then people said, is it true? I mean, is he really, do they still really do that sort of thing just so that they can sing? Why would anyone do that? I can remember thinking just that. Why would anyone do that? Money. And she doesn't eat. Cigarettes and champagne, that's all she lives on. And when she climbed up onto the stage, people said, my God, she looks 100 years old. What a life she must have led. And when she sang, I thought, I can remember thinking, how could anyone do that? I didn't sleep. When I said, well, who is she? Where can I hear her again? They said she would never sing again. It was to be the last time. They had paid her a fortune, and it was to be the very last time. There is only one surviving recording of her voice, and I own it. If there is a man with me, I make him go home at midnight. I have him make love to me, and I send him home. And at midnight, I pour one glass of champagne for myself, and one for her, and I sit there in the dark, and I listen to that voice. No, I'm not married, I do not have children, and I am as wealthy now as I have always been. Wealthier. Four years ago, I heard a rumor that she was still alive. I flew to Venice. She didn't appear. A year ago, a man telephoned me from Zurich, claiming to have a recording of her voice in his possession. It was a hoax. And 6 weeks ago, I received an invitation. And so, I have come. Everything's ready. I've even brought the money.
If they are all waiting, they can wait all fucking night. I'm not doing it, right?
Mm-hmm.
something to me. Speak to me. Sing to me. Sing to me. I brought the money. Aren't you going to sing?
Right.
Thank you.
Café des ovales.
Le casino de Paris.
Le Moulin Rouge. Les Folies Bergères. Le tout Paris 1931. Paris qui brille. Paris qui jase en 38. Paris, ville de joie.
Mon Dieu, quel navet.
Paris, ville de volupté. Paris en folie.
Très bien.
La folie de jour. La folie de nuit. Un soir en folie. Folie, folie. Étoile en folie. Un vent de folie. Folie de cœur. La folie de la
Giulio Cesare!
Le duc! Le prince! Le prince de Galles! Quelle aventure! Monsieur l'ambassadeur! Monsieur le comte! Gentlemen, the incredible house. The cardinal, Maréchal, Milord, Marquis, the Duke, the Prince, Ambassador, Monsieur le Comte, Cardinal, Maréchal, Milord, Marquis, Sarrasine.
Jean-Ernest Sarrasine.
Sometimes I think I've got him confused with someone else.
Well, I'm listening. I have come here in the middle of the night because I was invited, and I have come because...
You know, there were so many. He wasn't the first. He certainly wasn't the last. He was very young, I remember that.
I am paying you to sing. Want to see the money?
You know I can hardly remember.
Roma.
Oh.
Yes, it was in Rome at the Opera House.
L'Opera, 1753.
1750.
Yeah, in the summer of 1758. Yes, of course I was something to look at then. And a lot of people made good money to see me. Every night of the week they came. And matinee. Mesdames et messieurs, une vraie étoile. Ce soir, seulement je vous présente des plus grandes étoiles européennes. Avec quel plaisir je vous présente l'inoubliable et l'inoublié. Seigneur et belle dame, la grande diva, le courage. La prima donna, la stupenda, grosso lucro, messieurs, dames, d'Avinella.
Strange.
He said he loved me so much when he died.
I'm laughing, though they all say they loved me. Of course, I was something to look at then. People used to pay good money to see me every night of the week. They used to come and the matinees. And of course, it was his very first time. First time he'd ever been to the opera. I mean, his very first night it was. I said, ooh, he's nice. What's his name? And they said, "E francese, Monsieur Jean-Ernest Sarrasine." I thought, oh, Francese. Well, I saw him looking at me. And of course I didn't look at him. Oh, well, I didn't encourage him. Well, I don't like to encourage them. But I thought, well, if he likes it so much, I might as well try it again.
Lentore sospirante. E adesso l'ombre scese su.
to keep them thinking of me and to bring them to their knees. And the second night, well, there he was again in exactly the same seat and all on his own and all dressed up. I thought, here we go again. But there's another one. Well, it's sad. Sad, really. It's so fucking easy. So I waited right to the end of the number and I smiled at him. Just once.
She's so damn a donna.
By a woman.
By a sai, torturata. Ogni cantora, parla, guardami, son tosca o scarpa. Soffoca il sangue, muore dannato, muore, muore. Outside the stage door, he was almost weeping. I knew he wasn't sleeping when I went off stage. He cried out, more, more, but I didn't do an encore. I like them to say please. I like them to bring me flowers. I like them to bring me champagne. I like them to knock. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, a pair of parts of Tusk. Who told you you could come in here without knocking? Who told you you could write to me? Who told you you could? Do you think I live on champagne? What am I supposed to do with all these fucking flowers out of the shop?
Oh, yes, I'd love you to see you. Come in, come in. I'm so pleased to enjoy this. Tomorrow night, there's no performance. Monday night, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Pompeo, Cleopatra, Tosca, Norma.
Comparisce Norma col pugnale a mano. È valida, risoluta.
Norman appears with a knife. He stands over her sleeping children. Feel pity, and ever feel pity, and then ever pity yourself. They said to me, how do you feel? I said, I pity men who say they can't feel love, they said they're almost crying, and I was only trying.
Every single night of the Sunday, of course, that's church. Well, and the next, well, I thought at least he's got money. And the next night it was Medea. Medea! Well, she does it, you know. She kills her children. The great women, the perfect women, the women with knives! Tosca, Norma, Medea. And every night when they applauded, I was so tired sometimes I would stand there and I would want to laugh.
But I could laugh, I just couldn't help myself. I wondered what they thought they were watching.
I could see it winking, I knew what it was thinking.
And then it would be more applause, more flowers.
More flowers! Champagne! 16 letters in one afternoon! And then, on the 10th day!
On the 10th day! I was just in the chorus, you see. There is this fabulous scene where she goes mad, and she's wonderful in it. I love it. I just love it. And was he watching her?
Mm-hmm. Oh, no.
He was watching me. I hate it sometimes. They get their binoculars out. And they think if they look close enough.
Oh, of course, in those days I was something worth looking at. Every night of the week they used to come to see me. It was a different show every single night. And matinees. Rehearse the new routines in the morning. Costume fitting. Matinee. Sleep with the makeup on. More makeup on. The curtain rises! Curtain down. And they all said, you look so perfect, you're never tired. And I used to say, good, let's go out. Let's go somewhere amusing. Let's go somewhere where I can act crazy. I've been working all day. And they said, you look so wonderful when you come down the stairs holding the knife like that. So young, so strong.
Backstage.
Later that night.
I always love the first scene in Act Two. I'm not in it.
Femme du bal avec le cou, le bras, le corsage.
nue, une robe de satin gris et rose.
That's right, dear. Everyone has to have something to live off when they're old. This is all fake. You wouldn't think so to look at it, would you? This one's real.
L'amour pur. La poésie secrète. La beauté idéale. La beauté qui inspire l'amour. La beauté fatale.
That's right, dear. They always want to get into the dressing room. They want to see what you're really like. They want to watch you getting dressed. Like that. Get some going. Do we hear a knock on the door? And you say...
You'll just have to wait, I'm not ready yet.
Oh, come in. No, no, please. Do come in. I'm just getting dressed. Find yourself somewhere to sit down.
Be with you in a minute. Relax. I'll be right there. I'll bet you.
Shotgun slides slowly down, but you don't give nothing away. Brush out the hair, as if you don't care. But don't you give nothing away. Don't even look at him. Peel off one stocking. You love it. So shocking. Let him know that you're one of those girls. Slide off your bangles and things. Let him unclip your earrings. But don't let him touch those pearls. Let your guard fall over. Leave him wishing, hoping, groping. Something to say. Take a tip from me, sister. You wanna catch a mister? And don't you give nothing away. Let him pop the champagne. Now he's almost insane. But Rome wasn't built in a day. It's supper you need, and that's all you agree. So don't you give nothing away. Temperature rises. We are full of surprises. And there's that smart cafe, so gay. And just when you're leaving, and he's got trouble breathing, still don't give nothing away. He says, a kiss will be nice. Just rattle your eyes. And remember what mother would say. Oh, child of mine, take endless time. But don't you give nothing away. Meet her, I could introduce her. She's really very different in, you know, real life. Very different in private. Very easy to talk to. Nothing to be afraid of. You ready?
You're very late.
There she is. Just over there. Can't you see?
Go on, what are you afraid of?
Are you ready?
the ballroom. It's wonderful.
Oh, I'd love to. Is it this way?
Do you walk there?
No, never.
Can I see you again?
I expect you'll know most people. If you want me to introduce you, no, of course, it's really very approachable. Everybody says so, really. Everybody. So why don't you just go right up to her and ask her what she's really thinking? Most people do. She's really very charming, but, you know, quiet. Cheers. Again, coquette.
Oh, I always love that scene.
Bravo. Encore.
Mesdames et messieurs,
ladies and gentlemen, this next song is entitled Va tu me maîtriseras. En anglais, they always say they hate you.
Jeune fille sans honte, il t'a dit qu'avec lui la vie sera si calme. On est au point de croire ses promesses affolantes. Quand il dit qu'avec lui enfin tu seras aimé, oh tu le sais bien, oh tu sais. Bon de le voir allongé au lit comme un beau soldat avec ses cheveux et son corps nu. Quand nous rêvons au lit, quel fou nous sommes. Quand il dit qu'avec lui, enfin, tu seras aimé, oh tu le sais bien. Et t'entends encore de l'amour, le grand thème. Te trompe, croyant, t'as trouvé la seule exception. La musique s'éteint, ils sont tous les mêmes. Oui. Avec eux, enfin, tu seras aimé. Oh, tu le sais bien quand tu parles comme ça, mon Dieu, tu le sais. Au même temps qu'il parle, qu'il te maîtriserait. Quel que soit, je me dis non. Pourquoi se droguer? Pourquoi faire des boulevards? Mais je m'habille pour la nuit. Je trouve quelqu'un. Je me demande. Je vais. Dites-moi, c'est bon encore une fois.
Encore une fois, je voudrais te croire.
Avec toi, enfin, je suis vraiment aimé, mais je le sais bien, je le sais, chérie, si tu parles comme ça, quand le jour se lève, tu me mépriseras, tu me mépriseras.
Where is she? nights when they wanted something from you, and you knew you hadn't got it. Not that night, not that particular night. Someone comes to you backstage and says they're waiting, they need you. You are the solution to their problem, and they've paid. They've paid for what they're going to get from you, they've paid a lot of money, and they don't want it back. They want you to keep it, they want you to have it. They want you. You see, they know that you are perfect, and that you can do something for them that no one else can do. No one. So what did you do?
Good. Good. Early the next morning, Act Two, Scene Two. Recitativo, duetto, arios. La prima donna, Sarrasine.
Speaking to a woman.
Melina, you sembra.
And I said, oh, oh, you can never love me as I wish to love.
Do not ever ask me to love you.
me the world, the desert. I understand that. I see it all around me. I dream of it every night. Every night. When I dream, I can see love.
Do you think I love you the way he did? Understand love. I can see it. I can see how it works. I can see it all around me. I dream of it. Every night I sit there in the dark and I dream of it, and when I dream, I can hear love. I want it. I too ache for it, for love's different to any I was ever supposed or allowed or taught to imagine. Stronger. That's why I'm here, and that is why I brought the money.
Dacci, non vi parlare così.
Listen, monsieur.
If you love me,
don't look at
me. I love you. Oh, comment je vous aime.
Dacci, non mi parlare così.
my dear fellow. Our ambassador has asked me to invite you to accompany him to a private concert tonight. And when I tell you, La Zambinella will be there. La Zambinella. La Zambinella. Oh, La Zambinella, cried Sarrasine. I'm crazy about her.
And so's everybody else, dear.
Ah, oh, it's a tussle, man. Act two, scene three, the Palazzo of the Cardinal.
Sarrasine enters the salon where La Zambinella is preparing to sing. Sarrasine speaks to a fellow guest and asks, why is she dressed as a man? And the guest replies, she.
Oh, she.
You think she's a woman? La Zambinella came for Maria, don't you know? Why don't you know? Where are you from? What kind of city are you from? Surely
you know there are no women on the Roman stage. She's only 19 and she's making a fortune.
And we all know where the money is coming from.
Jean and the Sarrasine hardly even heard what the man was saying. He stood there and he watched her sing.
Whispering while I was singing. Garçon. Mignon. Pede. Tapet. Queen. We.
Go on, what are you afraid of?
Go on, girl. Sing!
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 19 years old. Never seen that much money in my life before. Suddenly there he was in my dressing room, I said. But I've never been paid in cash before. What do you expect me to do?
I'm sorry for that. I can't think too.
What did you expect me to do?
I cannot think like this. Je ne peux pas changer ce soir, c'est impossible. I can't, I'm sorry, I can't!
£5,000. A lot of money in those days. It's different now.
10 whole days. 10 whole days. From the second chorus. Where did you think the money came from? Now you can see where the money came from.
But I can't do it live. I don't want to do it tonight, it hurts, I'm sore. Can't you leave me alone just for one night?
Where did you think it came from? She earned it, and this is how she earned it.
But I don't want to do it tonight, I'm too sore.
I will pay you whatever you want.
Oh, but I can't do it tonight, I'm too sore, it hurts.
I am paying you to keep on singing.
Oh, of course I'll hang you, of course I'll agree with you.
Thank you. Now sing to me as you sang to me then, go on. Keep on singing, I'll pay you whatever. It doesn't matter what you say.
What are you afraid of?
People said what a life she must have led. Well, now I want to know. I'm paying you, and I want to know how you live.
Of course I do, Mom. Of course I love you. Yes, I like being with you. I love being with you. Yeah. I love the things you buy me. I love it when you kiss me. I love it when you fuck me. No. No, I never let anyone else touch me. I never let anyone else look at me.
Just make sure you get paid, that's all. More. I said more. I won't do it otherwise. I don't care if they're all waiting. They went all fucking night. I said more. 5,000. 8,000. Yeah, 8. It's different to 5. It's more. More.
Dignity, purity, honesty, skill, passion, courage,
found out the terrible truth, how did he feel, make me feel, how he felt, make me feel it. Tell me. Show me.
finale. L'atelier de l'artiste. Through the window we glimpse three cloaked figures, the cardinal's assassins. Half dead, frozen with horror, La Zanne Minella crouches in the corner, hardly daring to move or cry out for help. In this scene, Sarrasine speaks with the voice of one whose life has been forever changed. Dites-moi la vérité. Tell me the truth. La Zanne Minella collapses into a chair. La Zanne Minella collapses into a chair. La Zanne Minella falls to her knees.
I'm a
I beheld in you the woman of my dreams, and it was an illusion. One gesture of your feeble hand has overthrown my life. Aimé, être aimé, loved, to be loved. Now those are meaningless words for me, just as they are for you. Ce sont des mots vides de sens pour moi, comme pour toi. Pour moi.